I'm from an area where the Tories, historically, would never get a vote, especially middle class to lower class, if you would like, working class. My area, there's not one person would vote Tory, but people are doing it now, and they're voting for things what they don't agree with, but they're voting because there's no alternative. I think what they're doing is, you've got a list of leaders, or all the major parties, and what they're doing is they're ticking off the ones that they can't vote for because they've all got something wrong, or there's one reason that they can't vote for them, and then Theresa May is left at the end of every list that you make, if that makes sense.
If that makes sense, Neil, that should be in the op-ed pages of every newspaper in the country. That you've just unravelled British politics 2017.
Well. I'd like to think I've done
no,
that.
No, you have. Yeah. You're right, we're all going home now. I'm going to play records. I'm going to stick on Mantovani till Sheila Fogarty gets here.
Very funny, yeah. But that is...
patronising much.
Bit serious, though, you know what I mean? That's what
I think you're absolutely... I need to hear it from someone like you, because, of course, you know, I'm sitting here in my... What's it called this week? My metropolitan elite bubble or whatever, my mainstream media jaundiced world, whatever it may be. Sheffield, I mean, that's off the top of my head, that's classic. That's my mum grew up there. That's classic working-class Labour country.
The Tories have destroyed... And I'm not exaggerating, the Tories have destroyed 75% plus of Sheffield's industry. 75% plus. They've destroyed the city. What we're left with now is a nuclear bomb's gone off, and everything that's destroyed that doesn't work anymore, that factories that's closed down, industries that's closed down, you can get your way back, and it will always be down to something to do with the Tories funding cuts, privatisation.
And go back to 79, and you've got the mines being sort of ripped out of the equation as well. I mean, just in the interests of balance and fairness, I think you are also looking at globalisation. A lot of industry being moved to parts of the world where the production costs are a pittance compared to what they would be in Sheffield, and there are other factors as well. So 75% might be a little bit unkind, but. Yeah,
which is why I didn't blame it completely.
Yeah, exactly, exactly.
But I was careful not to blame it 100% on them, because I wouldn't do that. But what's happening now is you've got people, when you're in conversations, things like that, when you're in group discussions, you hear people, yeah, I'm voting Conservative. Yeah, I can't vote for Corbyn, he's an idiot. You know, I can't vote for Miliband because you can't take anything he says seriously. Or I'm not voting for Nick Clegg because he's just a liar and look what he did and he's just this, he's that. I'm not voting for Nigel Farage because he's just a joke. So everybody that is an option, if you like, to vote for, they've all got a reason why working class northern folk, they've all got a reason why you can't vote for them.
So they're voting for Theresa May because she's the only one who doesn't look as if the country would be circling the plug hole by tea time. Even if it does end up circling the plug hole by tea time, she's pulled off the perception trick of not looking like it would be.
Yeah, it's like jumping up,
God, what a caller.
It's like jumping off a cliff, and your option is, if you jump off the cliff with Theresa May, you're definitely going to break your leg. If you jump off the cliff with Jeremy Corbyn, you might be dead when you jump off cliff. So we'll go with Theresa May because we're only going to get a broken leg. That doesn't make it right. That just means that you're guaranteeing, if you like, in a way, that, like you said,
you're not going to die.
That you're not going to die. So what's happening is we don't have an option. And this is the problem.
This is the call that should go viral. This is the one, mate. This is the call that should go viral this week, because yeah, I mean, that image I have of the list of leaders, and there is an exception to this that I think we saw in Richmond, and I think we saw in the other by-election that wasn't in Joe Cox's old constituency, where Labour did very, very well, where you have where Jim in Oldham, the candidate up in Oldham. Yeah. Where Labour have a very strong local game, a very, very strong... So it's an ex-council leader, or it's someone who does have recognition breakthrough with the voters. But any election, any by-election, any constituency election come that is going to be decided according to the leaders of the main political parties, I think you've just described it better than any of the professionals have done. You just cross off everyone who you could never contemplate voting for whatever reason, and the only name left at the bottom, the sort of ball coming out of the bottom of the kaplunk game, is Theresa May.
That you just hit the nail on the head, and I hope I've done that too, but that is exactly...
Man, I just borrowed your nail.
Somebody, yeah, somebody shouldn't be winning election because the four names on the list, three of them were bad.
You got it. He's done it.
And then she's just the least bad. That doesn't make her right. What they're doing is wrong. Some of the policies what they've got are just absolutely unthinkable, that anybody from my city and my people, if you like, could be voting for her and that party. But it's happening because there's no alternative. So it's, when we're using language this morning, like yourself have used it, other callers have used it, oh, she's playing a blinder, she's doing this, she's doing that. She's not playing anything. The other three are playing that bad a game that it's unthinkable.
No, but she has brought in the UKIP vote. She's nullified the UKIP threat to the Tories, and that was deliberate and conscious.
Is the UKIP vote, though, something that... Should we be trusting people who agree with UKIP on anything other than immigration anyway? That's the only thing that they can talk about, immigration anyway. Well, I wouldn't let somebody from UKIP run me a bath. They might run me a country, but again, the voters that were going to vote for UKIP, again, yeah, she's stealing them, but that's not because UKIP are doing anything right or she's doing anything right. That's just because...
Yeah, you're right. I'm not talking principles, am I? I'm talking pragmatic tactics. I'm talking short-term political tactics. What would not get crossed out? What would a Labour leader look like that didn't get crossed off the list of you and your friends?
Well, you're asking me a question there that it could be anybody. One thing that I do know is it's not Jeremy Corbyn. That's 100% that it's not Jeremy Corbyn. It's probably not a Diane Abbott figure. It's definitely not an Ed Miliband figure, but that's not to say.
What was wrong with Ed Miliband? I think history judges Ed Miliband quite unfairly, but I also see that he didn't sort of cut through in your part of the world in any way whatsoever.
I don't think Ed Miliband. I think the problem with it is policy. Again, you said it to a caller earlier, and you were putting down Jeremy Corbyn, or he was being put down again. But he is. Like, if you listen to what he's actually saying, yes, he is the person that probably cares about people up north. And
yes.
But in an academic
sense rather than in a real sense, I think. You know what I mean. You know what I mean.
Yeah. He's the one that does care about people like me and people in my city and people in my... He's the one that does care the most, but he's not got a prayer of winning it because of who he is. So you need to find us... Well, I don't know how we're going to fight, but we need to find, like, a middle ground. You know, so...
Everyone is telling me this, including some sort of formerly quite highly placed Labour Party people that I bumped into the other night. They all describe themselves as politically homeless.
Yeah, that's...
So are your voters. So are the voters you're describing.
The North is politically homeless, James. The North is politically... When you listen to Question Time, Prime Minister's questions, things like that, when you listen to that, and Jeremy Corbyn comes on and he asks his questions from his letters, what he's had, and then you hear everybody, like, you watch Sky News, you listen to... and they're putting him down and they say, oh, is this... He failed to land a blow on Theresa May. The things what he said, the issues that he's bringing up, they're real issues. They're real issues. What matter to people like us and people that the letters that he's received, they're from real people. He's trying to deal with real issues, but unfortunately, he's just never going to win a vote. So Theresa May at the moment is winning,
laughing.
And that party is riding high for one reason and one reason only, and that's because the opposition isn't good enough to strike a blow on their party. But that doesn't mean that they're right and what they're doing is good for the country. And people need to stop. People need to stop and think when they say, oh, yeah, I'm going to vote Tory, I'm going to vote this. You need to stop and think and look at what it is that they're trying to achieve. Don't look at what Jeremy Corbyn's doing wrong. Don't look at what Labour's doing wrong. You know what I mean?
I know exactly. Mate, I'm going to have to go to the travel news before everyone starts calling for you to replace me as the presenter of this programme. Before I do that, who's your favourite politician ever?
Oh, that's a long one.
I'm
not going to say Dennis Skinner because I'll be laughed off at show.
No, you won't. Not this show.
I'm not too sure. I couldn't answer. I'll have a think. I'll call you back. How's that one?
I look forward to it. And then I can try and sort of gather up some Sheffield-based brownie points by telling you about my granddad's job at the Metropolitan Vicar Steelworks. 11:15, Metropolitan Bubble, moi.